Faustina the Elder, wife of Emperor Antoninus Pius, wore a distinctive and surprisingly modern-looking braided hairstyle. Faustina's 8-braid hairstyle is best appreciated from the profile and back. It coils up the head much like a French twist, terminating with a neat pile of narrow braids at the top. To interpret this ancient hairstyle, I'll use the following period-appropriate tools. 6 hair bodkins to section and control my model's thick, curly hair. A blunt needle of wood, bone, iron, or gold. Coarse thread colored to match the hair, and small scissors to cut the thread. I will use wool thread because it was the most common textile fiber of ancient Rome. Separate the hair into 2 equal halves from forehead to nape. With hair bodkins, divide and pin up 4 horizontal subsections from each half of the head. Each section should contain roughly equal amounts of hair. Starting at the nape, weave a 3-strand braid from each of the 8 subsections. Tie thread to a blunt needle and make a slip knot at its long end. Stitch through the base of the lowest right-hand braid and pass the needle through the slip knot. Twisting all the braids together, pull them toward the top of the head. Stitch the edge of the coil to the scalp hair to secure it. At the crown, align the braids in the palm of your hand. Stitch back and forth through the braids to create a flat, solid panel. Thank you. thread tightly around the ends to prevent unraveling. Turn the panel backward and hide the hair ends in the coil. Stitch the ends in place. Now stitch the lower edge of the panel to the scalp hair. When all feels secure, clip the thread and the style is complete. Adding a part ornament. To create this part ornament, I strung beads on a piece of medium weight wire. There is a loop at the top to help attach the ornament to the hair. Place the loop end near the braid. To get started, stitch in place through the loop a few times. Stitch down and up the length of the ornament. Stitch until all feels secure, then clip the thread.